live here anymore?
Oh no, they still live here. They live right across the pond there. But they decided to raise that Tudor home and to create what you see here. So Peter Pfeiffer and Associates worked with them to contour the land that you see. So when you came in, you took a gentle curve, you saw a piece of sculpture, it was taken away from your view when you went on another curve. All of that was by design. They worked with Charles Guathmey and Associates to design this building, this 9,000 square foot museum, in concert with the family home across the pond there. And they also work closely with artists in order to place the works that you see here. At Glenstone, one thing that you'll never see is a group show. So we like to delve deep into a single artist, as we've done here in this building with the Louise Bourgeois show. So all of the works on the inside are by her. Now, this piece here that we're going to go to in a few moments after we get two more on our tour is by Ellsworth Kelly. It was created in 2005, and it was meant to be the fulcrum for the property. So we're going to see that. We're also going to see the clay houses, which were created by Andy Goldsworthy. He actually bought the property and he used materials that he found on site, and he created these interesting little, some people call them huts, that we'll see today. Okay. And on the way back, you can feel free to walk through Sylvester, which was created by Richard Serra. And when we go down into the woods, you probably heard it on your way up, the sound installation by Cardiff and Miller. And it's rather interesting because you hear an amplified version of a forest, you hear choral music, you hear people walking, but you also hear the sound of combat. And that's all. The museum across the way is about 9,000 square feet, but the new museum is going to be about 5 times that size. So this piece is made from steel, and the Rales work closely with Ellsworth Kelly to place it onto the property, as well as to make sure it enacted his vision. So I love the fact that depending upon the season, the color changes. And the color doesn't actually change, but right now it looks sort of gray, right? Mm. Or quintessential Glenstone gray. But in other seasons and in other weather, it has sort of a bluish tint to it. Yeah, actually I can never remember the names of the grasses. I know we have 4 different types on the property. The installation's floor. And so I encourage you all to look through the fissures and tell me what you see. Careful about touching the materials.
What is the material?
Please don't touch.
Don't touch it.
Don't
touch
it.
Oh, you're not supposed to touch.
Yeah, it
cannot see a thing. What are we supposed to see?
So it's completely solid on the inside, and it's a process called rammed earth. So Andy Goldsworthy created a frame, if you will, and compacted the clay inside. And the things that you see in the fissures are hair. Animal hair, human hair, the hair of the founders are there, hair of the people who worked there at that time are there. And that is used, another way in which one will do that is to use straw. So that's used to have the clay hold a little bit more compactly.